Why is it worth studying the physical properties of soil before sowing? Soil is the foundation of a farmer's work and the source of their income. By understanding its structure and managing its properties, it is possible to maintain high fertility and achieve good yields. It is important to examine its physical properties before sowing. Soil consists of various components whose proper condition affects yields. The key factors are granular structure, humus content, soil type, and the presence of organisms such as earthworms. To assess soil condition, it is worth performing a soil profile analysis. To do this, dig 3 pits about 30 centimeters deep, one in a spot showing poor soil quality, one in a location favorable for crops, and one in an area untouched by cultivation. In each pit, a soil profile will appear. Take a photo of it and analyze the soil structure. Pay attention to the size of soil aggregates, especially in the upper layer. Aggregates should be up to 5 centimeters in size. This ensures that plants receive the right amount of water. Also check the granular structure. If you don't see it, the soil is too dry. Examine plant roots. If they grow sideways or upwards, the soil is compacted at that depth. Look for a plough pan or a thin compacted layer. Good soil should also have pores where water and air can accumulate. A penetrometer allows you to determine the depth of the plough pan, which helps adjust agrotechnical operations accordingly. Another method involves dropping a clod of soil from a height of 1 meter. Compact soil will break into smaller pieces. The number of particles sticking to the roots indicates the soil's ability to absorb water. It is also worth performing the so-called slump test. This involves placing a soil sample in a sieve immersed in water. Soil with a stable structure will remain intact, while unstable soil will dissolve. You can assess soil texture by rolling a sample between your fingers. This helps identify whether it is sandy, clay, or silty. The presence of earthworms in the soil indicates fertility. Their population can be measured by digging small pits and counting the worms in the samples. The humus content of the soil can be analyzed in a laboratory. Humus affects the soil's ability to store water and nutrients. Such tests are best conducted after harvest, before fertilization. It is recommended to perform them every 4 years, although climate change may require more frequent analyses. After completing the analyses, you can implement appropriate agrotechnical practices. For sandy soils, spring tillage should be limited and organic matter added. Silty soils require leveling rollers, while clay soils may benefit from abandoning traditional plowing and using a subsoiler instead. To increase humus content, it is worth adding organic material, such as straw and plant residues. Soil testing helps optimize farming practices and improve crop quality. If you are interested in more useful information or face challenges in your crop production, visit our blog at rolmako.com/blog, where we explain everything you need to know to achieve the best results.